True confession, I do not speak perfectly formed sentences in one take when I'm on camera. But I will say, I have a super slick way to pick the exact right part of the take, and it actually works on any editing platform, but I'll be demonstrating in Premiere. This is gonna be good. Howdy, my name is Jeff Bartsch, and this is Story Greenlight, where we're all about helping you as content creators use creative video editing and powerful storytelling to help you connect with your audience, turn up the impact of your work, and to change people's lives. That's what we're all about. So if you're new to the channel, consider hitting the subscribe button and hit that bell so you don't miss a single video. Now, here's the thing. You can't really focus on the creative side of video editing if you don't have the right workflow to let your brain do what it's supposed to do. So here's a little tip on workflow. Okay, so I'm in Premiere here, and just as a disclaimer, this idea works the best if you actually have a lot of footage. Like if you're doing a long piece with a lot of talking heads or a lot of documentary footage that you need to pull selects from. Because if you only have a few clips, I mean, you can just keep that in your head and just move on. But in the meantime, what we have here, I've selected some of my source clips for this current thing that I'm working on. Just select them all, drop them into the sequence, set them to frame size, and here is what we have. Okay, so then the first step is you want to look at your waveforms and be like, okay, well, I can see these gaps here. So you can see.
What's up, everyone? My name is Jeff Bartsch, and this is Story Greenlight, where we're all about helping content creators like you
blah,
use
blah,
creative
blah.
Writing and powerful storytelling so you can connect with your audience, turn up the impact of your message, and ultimately change people's lives.
So that's what we're all about. Okay, that's fine. So we'll just say that that's a clip that we want to keep. I'm going to use the razor tool. I'm going to mark the beginning and the end of that. Go back to the selection tool, option up. I'm going to bump that clip to an upper track. And what ends up happening, you're going to end up with all your selected takes, and say, let's just say like this one here.
What's up, everyone? My name is Jeff Bartsch.
And we'll just say that that's the most amazing take in the history of the whole world. Razor that puppy there, go back to selection, option up. And what happens is you have your selected bits visually separated on your timeline. And when you have a long piece, like this piece that I'm doing here, when you get an extended thing like that, you end up having all these selects here. You can lasso them and you can select them, say copy. And I'm just gonna go to this work string here and I'm just gonna go downstream and say Apple paste. And then here's the super slick thing. While they're all selected, go to sequence and close gaps. And what ends up happening is you have your entire group of selects all next to each other. You don't have to think about, okay, well, this one good thing was way back here in the other take, and then I've got to put it together with that thing. It's like it's all in one spot. You can instantly say yes, no, swap that, yes, 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 no, and before you know it, you have a complete assembly of your first cut. You can also do this and keep the takes that you aren't going to use in the cut, but you still actually kind of like this one.
Blog and to get into the edit and put it together in a way that doesn't. Hello. Not helping. Thank you. We're done. Good.
Yeah, maybe an outtake somewhere. Who knows?
To see this video when it's done, go here. And if you want to check out another video, go here. And in the meantime, my name is Jeff Bartsch. This is Story Greenlight. And remember, keep telling your stories because you matter, your message matter, and people need to hear what you have to say. I'll see you next time.